Well, hello there, Eric Griffith here again with Mobile Tech Services in Mobile Tech Studio B, and today I've got a Google issue. Today, Google has been hacked by kids. Well, not really hacked, they've just found a workaround that has allowed them to re-enter the classroom Google Meet after the teacher has left, reset, kicked them out, and done all the steps that we've encouraged our teachers to do in order to prevent students from jumping back in. In short, what they're doing is, as they're first clicking on the link, they're going to the top of the screen, right-clicking on the tab, and hitting duplicate, and then just joining one of those two tabs. Then, once they're kicked out later in the day, they just jump back into that previous tab, and it's sort of like leaving your foot in the door, as my buddy John Sowalsh says, right? So you leave your foot in the door, and then you can re-enter again. I say it's more like taping the door open so that when you closed it, it still looks closed. You're pretty sure you did everything right, but later the student goes back in and opens the door, right? So here's exactly how they're doing it. Towards the end, I'm going to talk to you about Bloxy, which is a third-party solution that allows us to monitor student Chromebooks and devices from the teacher's perspective, and they can prevent multiple devices or multiple logins at the same time. So this is an expensive fix to do it, but it's what we have today until Google resolves the issue. Today's date is January 7th, 2021. So this has been an issue for a while, and students are slowly figuring out how to do this. Okay, so let's jump over to my teacher classroom and show you exactly what they're doing. Just like always, we'll start with a Google Classroom right here. We'll go ahead and join it, and I'm going to go ahead and mute myself here. Then let's jump over to my student Chromebook right here, and we'll go ahead and join this as well. All right, so here's the tip, here's the trick that they're doing, the hack. They're going right up here to the top, they're right clicking, and then they're clicking duplicate. So you can see right up there, oops, I did not click duplicate, I clicked pin. Yep, so now they're hitting duplicate, and so there's two instances of the Google Meet right there. In fact, I want to say unpin and unpin right here. So there are two instances of the Google Meet. And so what they're doing is they're joining one instance like that. Okay. And so this is how they're doing it. Once they've gone through, let's jump over to my teacher desktop, and the teacher has followed all of our instructions on how to normally remove students. They're going to click right there, click down there, and then they'll end up clicking remove, right? You can't see it right now because I'm in the way. There we go. They'll end up clicking remove, and they'll get the student out of there, and then they will successfully end the Google Meet as they're supposed to, right? And then what the other thing I've had them do is go down and reset their Google Meet in order to prevent the student from logging in again, right? So you can see, as from the teacher's perspective, they've followed all of these steps. They've done it correctly. Unfortunately, still on the student side, as the student logs back in, you can see that they've been removed from that one meeting, but they've still got their foot in the door on the other one. So they can still go back and they can still join. And unfortunately, it still works. So you can see up here at the top, they are the only participant in the class, unattended. Okay. So what we found out is students have been doing this and meeting after school to collaborate. I don't know. But anyway, my fix for this is to get a third-party solution like Bloxy, GoGuardian, or Securely. All of these have student monitoring applications built into them, or are additional monitoring applications so that teachers can see the thumbnails of student desktops in real time during their classroom. And so what we'll have to notice, or what the teachers will have to be aware of, is that if a student has multiple instances open of Google Meet, then what's going to have to happen is they're going to have to close one of them. Or at the end, they can just say, okay, close all the tabs on your desktop. All right. So the teacher has the ability to close this out and prevent this from happening, but only with a third-party system like Bloxy. Bloxy is B-L-O-C-K-S-I, and their website is bloxy.net. Currently, they're my favorite. I used to be a GoGuardian fan back in the day, hence the blue water bottle and the raccoon socks that I'm wearing, because that's their mascot. But in recent times, they've gotten pretty pricey, And I, as a tech director, former tech director, who is fiscally conscious about how much money I have to spend, if you're in a bind, Bloxy is very easy to get started and just get up and running with and train your staff on. So anyway, that's my recommendation on how to fix it. So anywho, I hoped this video would shed some light on an issue. I've already reported this to Google, so hopefully they're on it. And they're looking to find a way to prevent students from re-entering. So, if you enjoyed the video and I've shed a light on a problem that you didn't even know you had, give me a thumbs up and maybe a subscription. And as always, I hope you have a griftastic day. Thanks.